Welcome to this clinical skills video for venipuncture using a Vacutainer system. Prior to performing this procedure on a patient, you must ensure that you have explained to the patient the procedure you're about to perform, ensuring that you've confirmed the patient's identity. You must then also ensure that the patient is comfortably positioned with the elbow extended and supported. You must ensure that you then wash your hands thoroughly using the 11-stage approach. The equipment you require for venipuncture using the Vacutainer system is the appropriate tray, which will have been thoroughly cleaned prior to the procedure, a tourniquet, a Vacutainer, the appropriate size needle, of which there's two sizes, the green is a 21 gauge and the black is a 22 gauge. The appropriate blood bottles for the sample that you are about to take, ensuring that you have the correct blood bottles for the bloods that you require and that you are using the correct order of draw. You must then attach the needle to the Vacutainer holder. Palpate and inspect for the vein prior to tourniquet application, and then apply the tourniquet firmly but not excessively tightly. You must then repalpate for the vein prior to the procedure. Inform the patient that the needle will be inserted and what they're likely to feel. You then must remove the cover from the needle. Insert the needle in line with the vein with the bevel up at an angle no greater than 45 degrees. Maintain the position of the needle whilst inserting the blood tube and then wait for a sufficient amount of time for the tube to fully fill. Remove the tube whilst retaining the position of the needle and replace with the second tube as necessary. Remembering that for certain samples, such as the blue bottle that is used for clotting and INR, we must fill fully to the line. Ensure that all the samples are mixed appropriately by rocking. Once you have obtained all your samples, release the tourniquet before removing the needle, and then remove the needle in a single smooth movement. Apply the needle safety device and dispose of in the sharps bin. Ensure that you've applied adequate pressure on the wound before applying a plaster or a dressing, and then adequately labelling the blood bottles and completing the lab request forms.
Remembering the only samples that cannot have patient identifiable labels on are the pink bottles used for cross-match or group and save. These bottles must only ever be handwritten. Ensure the patient's comfort at the end of the procedure and ensure the samples are sent in a timely manner. It is the responsibility of the person who has ordered the blood test to check the results.
In summary, prepare the patient and confirm their identity. Wash your hands. Assemble and prepare all equipment using an aseptic non-touch technique. Identify and palpate the appropriate vein. Insert the needle no more than 45 degrees. Ensure you have the correct order of draw, mixing the samples adequately. Remove the needle in one sharp movement. Dispose of sharps and equipment safely. Label and document request forms and blood bottles appropriately, and send the samples to the lab in a timely manner.